Good morning, students. So today we have to do some revision from the chapter trigonometry. Is it clear? So now here in trigonometry, in class 10 already we get the chapter. I mean class 10 or trigonometry chapter to paisilo. So that I mean bahut kini formula hikisilo. So he trigonometric formula kini ama kya class 11 or ako dorkar hobo. For that reason we have to revise this chapter again. To amar jikini complex number chapter complex number তোমার চ্যাপ্টারটো আছে তাত আমার পোলার ফর্মত এই ত্রিগোনামিতি পার্টটোর বহুত একটা ডাঙর রোল আছে সো হে ত্রিগোনামিতির বস্তুখিনি আমি ভালকে ক্লিয়ার করিবর কারণে আমি মেইনলি ইয়াত কি করিম আমি ইয়াত ফার্স্ট অফ অল এই ত্রিগোনামিতি পার্ট আমি ক্লিয়ার করে লম সো দ্যাটস হোয়াই এট স্টার্টিং হিয়ার ইন দিস ত্রিগোনামিতির চ্যাপ্টার সো দ্য ফার্স্ট ওয়ান ইন ক্লাস টেন হোয়াট উই গেট মেইনলি উই গেট থ্রি আইডেন্টিটিস আমি কি পাইছিলো তাত মেইনলি তিনটা আইডেন্টিটিস পাইছিলো অ্যান্ড দিস থ্রি আইডেন্টিটিস আর If you see here, one by one, if we write, the first one is, so first one, if you see, sine square theta plus cos square theta equals to 1, where theta is the angle. In class 10, if you write A, then it is no problem here. So this one we write sine square A plus cos square A equal to 1. So after that, now the next one is here, we have to write. The second formula is here, sec square theta equals to, this one we have to write 1 plus tan square theta. So this one we have to write 1 plus tan square theta. And the third one is here, cosec square theta. So that's why here we write cosec square theta equals to 1 plus cos square theta. So 1 plus cos square theta. So mainly these three are the formulas here. So these three identities we get in class 10, isn't it? Sin square theta plus cos square theta equal to 1, sec square theta equal to 1 plus tan square theta, and the last one is cosec square theta equal to what? 1 plus cos square theta. Is it clear? So these three identities we get in class 10. Now with respect to this, there some more complementary ratios, some ratios are also we get there, isn't it? So now if we check out here the ratios or the identities here, one by one. Let's see here. Next, we have to discuss here the ratios. Now, the next one is here, trigonometric ratios. So, in class 10, already we get this trigonometric ratios here. So, if you see this triangle now here, if you see this triangle here, a right angle triangle we consider here, any angle, either you can choose this one or this. So, suppose if we consider this one and this angle is suppose we consider theta. If this angle is theta here, so angle and 90 degrees, so that means this AB is included under theta and 90 degree, isn't it? So that's why this side is what? This, and opposite of this theta angle is what? Perpendicular. So that's why we can say this one is perpendicular, which one we denoted by P, and this one is this, isn't it? Which one we denoted by B, and this part is what? Hypotenuse H, which one we denoted by hypotenuse, isn't it? So now here in this case, if you see, this one is base and this one is perpendicular. So now if we consider this one is a right angle triangle, so from here lots of ratios we get. So in case of sine, there is a definite formula for sine. So now in this case, if you see here sine theta, so sine theta equal to what? Perpendicular by hypotenuse. So perpendicular is BC and here it is hypotenuse, isn't it? So that's what you have to write here, perpendicular by hypotenuse. In class 10 we get this type of results, isn't it? So similarly here, if we take another one, suppose if we write cos theta, so cos theta equal to what we have to write? Base by hypotenuse. So here base is which one? AB, and the hypotenuse is what? Here AC, so that's why we have to write base by hypotenuse. So in this way, lots of trigonometric ratios like tan, sec, cosec, cot, all the trigonometric ratios through this right angle triangle, easily we can identify or easily we can find out here, isn't it? So this one is about trigonometric ratios. So now after trigonometric ratios, now here we have to measure some results here. Like the first one is here, degree measure. So degree measure in class 10 or 7, 8, 9, 10, all of you know how to measure degree, isn't it? So very simple this one. So if we check out this one here, suppose this point and this one is the initial line here. If this one is the initial line here, easily we can measure this whole angle is what? Complete angle is what? Degree here. This one is total how much? 360 degree. So one more thing here.
How can we measure the angle? So mainly we get two types of angles. All of you know this one? So if you see here, how can we measure the angles? So in case of angle, if you see here, suppose one line we consider this one and another one we consider here. So this point is known as, this one is known as vertex. All of you know this vertex. And this line is known as initial line. Initial line, is it clear? And this line is known as terminal line or ending line, whatever you can say. So this type of diagram in physics also you get this one, vertex, initial line and terminal line. So from this initial line, if one angle create to this terminal line, in which direction? In anti-clockwise direction. In this case we get a positive angle. In this case what we get a positive angle. Is it clear? Initial line, terminal line, and this one is the vertex. If any angle start from initial line in anti-clockwise direction, then what we get? Then we get a positive angle. So if you see here the direction, in which direction it moves? In anti-clockwise direction. That's why here the complete angle is how much? 360 degree. Is it clear? Okay. Now if you see another example here or another diagram, if you see here, which one? Suppose, and again one initial line we consider here, and this one is the vertex. If you see, this one is the vertex and this one is the initial line. Again, if we consider initial line. Now in this case, if the terminal line is this one, in this case, from this initial line, if any angle create, this angle create in which direction? In clockwise direction. So in this case what we get a negative angle. Is it clear? So this one is the difference between negative angle and positive angle. So in clockwise direction, if we measure, then we get a negative angle, or if we measure in anti-clockwise direction, then we get a positive angle. Is it clear? So in case of degree measure, complete one revolution here, isn't it? So that's why the angle is how much? 360. If you see here, the vertex is here, the lines are these two, initial line, terminal line. So if one angle create from here, if you see anti-clockwise direction, so that's why angle is how much? 180 degree. Is it clear? Okay. Now if you consider another example here, suppose one line here, this one, the vertex is here, at this place vertex, this one is the initial part and this one is the terminal part. And if the angle creates in this way, no doubt here also we get 180 degree. In this case also we get what? 180 degree here. But the angle moves in which direction? In clockwise direction. So that's why the angle is what? Here negative angle. So that's why we have to write here minus 180 degree. Is it clear? So this type of angles are here we mention as a degree measure. Is it clear? So in trigonometry chapter in class 11, we have to discuss more briefly here. Mainly here what we have to know, degree, how can we measure the degree, what is positive angle, what is negative angle, we have to know here. Is it clear? In clockwise direction, negative angle, in anti-clockwise direction, positive angle. And for this we get two lines, initial line and terminal line. Is it clear? Okay. After degree measure, so now next one is very important topic here, which one is radian measure. So this radian measure already you get in physics. Now here again, if you see this radian measure, how can we measure? So now in this case, first of all, what we need here? We need a unit circle. Unit circle means what? In case of unit circle, the radius always 1. If the radius is 1, then we can mention as a unit circle. So now in this case, if you see this diagram, so here we consider a unit circle. So if unit circle, their radiuses are what? 1. So that's why radius OA is the radius, OB is the radius, here we consider 1. So in anti-clockwise direction if we measure here the angle here. So how can we measure this angle? So this one is totally depend on this line from A to B. So in class 10, this type of arc we get is not it, and it is known as what, arc length. In class 10, in area related to circle, this type of diagram we have done, sector, arc length, is not it? So this from here A to B, this one is known as arc length. Arc length, is it clear? So if it is arc length from A to B, what is the length here? 5. So now if we consider a unit circle, if we consider a unit circle where the radius is 1, then in this case, whatever the arc length we get here, this arc length we can consider, we can measure as a radian. So that's why if the arc length is here 5, so that means here the angle is how much we get here? 5 radian. When this one is an unit circle. মনত থাকিব নে যেতিয়া এটা চাৰ্কেলৰ ইউনিট চাৰ্কেল হয়, ইউনিট চাৰ্কেল মানে কি হয়, ৰেডিয়াছ 1 হয়, তেতিয়াহ'লে ইয়াৰ যিটো আৰ্ক লেন্থ হ'ব, সেই আৰ্ক লেন্থটোৱে তাৰ এংগলটো হ'ব। ছাৰ সেই এংগলটো আমি কি বুলি ৰিপ্ৰেজেণ্ট কৰিম? 5 ৰেডিয়ান। দিছ ওৱান ইজ ন'ন এজ ৰেডিয়ান মেজাৰ। ইজ ইট ক্লিয়াৰ? ইউনিট চাৰ্কেল লাগিব আৰু আৰ্ক লেন্থ লাগিব। ইউনিট চাৰ্কেল আৰু আৰ্ক লেন্থ যদি পাওঁ, যিটো আৰ্ক লেন্থ হ'ব সেইটোৱে তাৰ ৰেডিয়ান মেজাৰ হ'ব। চ' দেটছ ৱাই উই ৰাইট হিয়াৰ 5 ৰেডিয়ান। ইয়াৰ জেগাত যদি এইটো 5 ৰেডিয়ান নহ'লে, আৰ্ক লেন্থ যদি 10 হোৱা হ'লে 10 ৰেডিয়ান হ'ল। ইজ ইট ক্লিয়াৰ? ভেৰি চিম্পল, দিছ ওৱান ইজ এবাউট ৰেডিয়ান মেজাৰ। অ'কে, নাও উই ন' ডেট দ্য চাৰ্কামফাৰেন্স অফ এ চাৰ্কল, ৱাট ইজ দ্য ফৰ্মুলা অফ এ চাৰ্কামফাৰেন্স অফ এ চাৰ্কল? টুৱাইচ পাই আৰ। ইফ দ্য ৰেডিয়াছ ইজ 1, ডেট মিনছ এ ইউনিট চাৰ্কল। চ' ৱাট ইজ দ্য চাৰ্কামফাৰেন্স অফ এ ইউনিট চাৰ্কল? এটা ইউনিট চাৰ্কলৰ চাৰ্কামফাৰেন্স কিমান? দ্য ইউনিট চাৰ্কল বুলি কোৱা মাত্ৰকে তাৰ ৰেডিয়াছটো কিমান হয়? Radius 1. So if radius 1, if r equals to 1, then obviously the circumference of a unit circle is what? Twice pi. Because the circumference of a circle twice pi r, if the radius is 1, so easily you can say twice pi. Is it clear? So that means if you see here, twice pi circumference, some circumference means if we start from this B and if we rotate this one, evolve up to one complete revolution. বিৰ পৰা ষ্টাৰ্ট হৈ পেলাই যদি এটা কমপ্লিট ৰিভলিউশ্যন হয় ইয়াৰলৈকে, তেতিয়াহ'লে সেইটো কিমান হ'ব? তোমাৰ ইউনিট চাৰ্কেলৰ কমপ্লিট ৰিভলিউশ্যন হ'লে তাৰ চাৰ্কামফাৰেন্সটো হৈ যাব তোমাৰ টুৱাইচ পাই। চ' ইয়াৰ পৰা ইয়ালৈকে যেতিয়া লেন্থটো 5 আছিলে, তেতিয়া ৰেডিয়ান মেজাৰটো আমি কি লিখিছিলোঁ? 5 ৰেডিয়ান, হয় নে নহয়? চ' যদি আমি বিৰ পৰা ষ্টাৰ্ট কৰি পেলাই যদি আকৌ বিত যদি আমি খতম কৰোঁ, তেতিয়াহ'লে ইয়াৰো এটা লেন্থ থাকিব। দিছ হোল লেন্থ ইজ হাউ মাছ? দ্য হোল লেন্থ ইজ হিয়াৰ টুৱাইচ পাই। Because the circumference of this circle, if unit circle, the whole length is twice pi. So if the whole length is twice pi here, the angle is how much here? Angle is how much? Twice pi radian. Is it clear? Yes sir. A-r pura b huar karne, tumar A-r pura b huar karne, yet length to 5 thokar karne, ami yet 5 radian likhi chilo. তেনেকৈ যদি আমি এটা কমপ্লিট ৰিভলিউশ্যন এটা যদি চাওঁ, ইয়াৰ পৰা বিৰ পৰা ষ্টাৰ্ট কৰি যদি আকৌ বিত খতম কৰোঁ, তেতিয়াহ'লে ইয়াৰ হ'ল এংগলটো কিমান? কমপ্লিট ৰিভলিউশ্যন টুৱাইচ পাই, তাৰমানে এংগলটো কিমান হ'ব তেতিয়াহ'লে? টুৱাইচ পাই ৰেডিয়ান। ইজ ইট ক্লিয়াৰ? চ' ডেটছ ৱাই ইজিলি উই কেন চে ওৱান কমপ্লিট ৰিভলিউশ্যন অফ দ্য ইনিচিয়েল চাইড অৰ ইনিচিয়েল লাইন ছাবটেন্স এণ্ড এংগল অফ হাউ মাছ? টুৱাইচ পাই ৰেডিয়ান। যদি অ' বিটো যদি আমাৰ ইনিচিয়েল চাইড বা ইনিচিয়েল লাইন হয় আৰু টাৰ্মিনেল চাইড হয়, তেতিয়াহ'লে ইয়াৰ কমপ্লিট ওৱান ৰিভলিউশ্যনত কিমান এংগল হ'ব, চাৰ্কামফাৰেন্স কিমান হ'ব? টুৱাইচ পাই হ'ব। তেতিয়াহ'লে ইয়াৰ এংগলটো কিমান হ'ব? Twice pi radian. Is it clear? So for that reason here, what you have to write? If you see here, 360, one complete revolution means how much? 360 degree. So that's why we have to write here, twice pi radian. Twice pi radian equals to 360 degree. Is it clear? At a complete revolution of kimanai, 360 degree, and which one also we can write twice pi radian. Is it clear? Okay, so now here, after getting this one, now there is a relation. There is a relation between degree measure and the radian measure. So we have to discuss this one next. Okay, now the next one is the relation between degree measure and radian measure. So it ami next ami ki korim, ami degree measure or radian measure relation to find out korim. So how can we find out this one? Let's see here. So very simple. one complete revolution. Complete revolution hole ki man hoy angle 360 degree aur circumference ki man asile twice pi. So that's why the radian is what twice pi already we find out, isn't it? So that's why we have to write here twice pi radian. So twice pi radian. So twice pi radian easily we can write this one is the complete revolution. That means we can write here 360 degree. Is it clear? And from here, if we calculate this to pi radian, so pi radian equals to easily we can write here 180 degree. Is it clear? So in our mathematics, we easily omitted this radian. I mean radian to ki karo? I mean nilikho. So in place of 360 degree, আমি যদি রেডিয়ানটো যদি রেডিয়ান মেজাৰ বুলি যদি রেডিয়ানটো যদি মেনশ্যন নকৰোঁ আমি তাৰ জেগাত আমি কি লিখিব পাৰিম ইন জেনেৰেল আমি নিলিখোঁ তাৰ জেগাত আমি কি লিখোঁ টুৱাইচ পাই টুৱাইচ পাই মিনচ ইট ইজ হুৱেন উই ৰাইট এনি এংগল ইন টাৰ্মছ অফ ইন ফৰ্ম অফ দ্য পাই আমি যেতিয়া এটা ৰিজাল্ট আমি পাইত লিখিম তেতিয়াহ'লে সি সদায় কি হ'ব এটা ৰেডিয়ান মেজাৰ হ'ব আৰু যদি ডিগ্ৰীত এনেকৈ যদি লিখোঁ তেতিয়াহ'লে ই কি হ'ব এটা ডিগ্ৰী মেজাৰ হ'ব আমি ইন জেনেৰেল ৰেডিয়ান মেজাৰ লিখোঁতে ৰেডিয়ানটোৰ লগত নিলিখোঁ চ' ডেটছ ৱাই টুৱাইচ পাই ইকুৱেল টু 360 ডিগ্ৰী ইজ ইট ক্লিয়াৰ চ' নাও হিয়াৰ ইফ ইউ কেলকুলেট দিছ টু চ' পাই ৰেডিয়ান ইকুৱেল টু হোৱাট 180 ডিগ্ৰী চ' ইন জেনেৰেল আমি যেতিয়া ৰেডিয়ানটো অমিটেড কৰি দিম ইন জেনেৰেল হোৱাট উই ৰাইট চ' আমি উই ৰাইট পাই মিনচ 180 ডিগ্ৰী চ' দিছ ওৱান ইজ দ্য ডিগ্ৰী মেজাৰ 180 এণ্ড পাই ইজ হোৱাট দ্য ৰেডিয়ান মেজাৰ ইজ ইট ক্লিয়াৰ চ' হিয়াৰ ইন ট্ৰিগনমেট্ৰি ইন ক্লাছ 11 in class 10 we calculate in degree measure now in class 11 each and every question we have to convert we have to write in radian measure ami radian measure likhim is it clear ami ti tale yat ki hal likhim radian measure likhim so there is a relation between degree and radian measure and the relation is this one pi equal to 180 degree and from here we get two results yar pore ami duta result uliyaba paru so easily we can find out two results The first result is if you see here pi equal to 180 degree. So if we write here pi radian equal to 180 degree, if we cross multiply this pi, then what will remain here? 1 radian. So 1 radian equal to how much? 180 by pi. So that's why we have to write here 1 radian. 1 radian equals to 180 by pi. Is it clear? So just we have to cross multiply this pi, then here what will remain? 1. So 1 radian equals to 180 by pi. Pi to cross multiply. And another result if we get here, if we cross multiply this 180 degree, then what will remain here? Only 1 degree remains. So that's why in this case we have to write here 1 degree equals to pi by 180. So this one is the relation between degree measure and radian measure. Is it clear? Okay, now from these two results, if you see here 1 radian equal to 180 by pi and 1 degree equal to pi by 180. So from these two easily we can convert radian into degree, degree into radian. You see here if any result given to us in radian, suppose 1 radian formula we know, if suppose 20 radian given or whatever some radians are given, you have to convert this one into or degree measure. So just you have to apply this result. And similarly here degree, if we 1 degree, then here suppose some radians given, so easily we can find out. So if 1 degree equal to pi by 180, so 30 degree equal to how much? Pi by 180 into 30, if we write, then easily we can convert. Similarly 1 radian equal to 180 by pi, if you write here 20 radian, then 20 radian easily we can convert into degree measure. 20 radian equal to 180 by pi into 20. So in this way we can convert into radian to degree, degree to radian. Is it clear? So in trigonometry these things are already given, so in your class 11 later on we have to discuss. Now mainly you have to know what is radian measure. So pi means 180 and twice pi means 360 degree. So in trigonometry here whatever we have to do, all results are we have to write in radian measure, not degree measure. Is it clear? Okay, now after this one, now next another very important point is what? The rule. One rule is here and the rule is what? ASTC rule. So I think all of you know this ASTC rule here. What you have to do here, let's see. So here mainly if you see here x, x dash, y, y dash. So this one is known as xy plane, isn't it? So here how many quadrants are there? 4 quadrants. First quadrant, second quadrant, third quadrant and fourth quadrant. I think all of you know this one. So which one we represent by first quadrant? 1. So second quadrant and this one is third quadrant and this one is what? Fourth quadrant. Is it clear? So these are the main quadrants here, and in this case ASTC rule. That means what is the meaning of this one? A means all. S means what here? Sign. AST. Here if you see T means what here? 10. And here C means what here? Cos. So I think the opposite of sine is what? Cosec, 10, cot, cos, sec. And here all. That means what here? ASTC. If you see the result here, if any angle lies on this first quadrant, any angle, that means any trigonometry function, if we consider sine, cos, tan, cot, whatever, any trigonometry function, if lies on first quadrant, that means all the results are here positive. Here, that's why we write all. Here, all the results are positive. Is it clear? So, in second quadrant, if you see here as sine written, sine, the opposite of sine is what? Cosec. So, that means any value, if we get here in this quadrant, in second quadrant, only sine and cosec positive. If any other angle, if we get here, suppose cos, sec, tan or cot, if we get in this case, here, other four are what? Negative. Other four angles are, if we get, negative. So that means, how can we get this result? Let's see here. Suppose, 10 pi minus theta. If you see here, complete angle pi minus theta, that means back to second quadrant. Pi plus theta, that means move to third quadrant. Pi minus theta, that means back to second quadrant. So that means we need the result of 10. So what is the value of 10 here? Negative. So that's why in this way, if you see here 10, that means here only 10 and cot are positive, other all are negative. The advanced students already, they know this one. So next one is cos. Here cos sec, that means in fourth quadrant only cos and sec positive, otherwise other all are negative. Other any values if we want, then in this quadrant other all are negative. So this one is about ASTC rule. Is it clear? So why we need this ASTC rule? Now in next topic we know what we need this one. What is the importance of this for all sec ASTC? Why we need this one? Now we know in our next topic. Is it clear? Okay. So now after getting ASTC rule, now you see how can we find out the result. Suppose if any result if you want or if you need, suppose sine in class 10 you get this one, 90 minus theta. Isn't it? So 90, that means degree measure. So sine 90 minus theta in class 10 we get this result is what? Cos theta. Isn't it? All of you know this one, 90 minus theta. So here, this one if we write in radian measure, so here 90 written, so that means it is degree measure. So if we write this one in radian measure, so what you have to write here? Pi by 2 minus theta equal to cos theta. So this one is radian measure, you see. Is it clear? The first one is degree measure and the second one is radian measure. Why radian? Because here pi written. If anywhere if you get pi, then it is radian measure. If we get number, then it is degree measure. So sine 90 minus theta equal to cos theta. All of you know this one. But if we get more value, if we get more than 90, then how can we identify the result here? This one is very important. So there is a technique to remember this. Is it clear? So now you see here, suppose sine, if we write again the degree measure, this one is the first one, then the second one, if you see here, sine 180 minus theta. So if anyone asks you, what is the answer of this result? Clear? So now in this case, you see here, how can we verify this one? So 180 means this result we can write here, multiple of 2 into 90 minus theta. So each and every time we have to calculate the result like in this way. The multiple of 90 we have to identify. So here you see 90, the multiple of 90 what you have to write? 1 into 90 we have to write. And in this case what you have to write? 2 into 90. So this one is the difference. So in this case what we write? 1 into 90. And in this case what you have to write? 2 into 90. So now after writing this one, 2 into 90. Now here if the multiple is here even multiple. Even multiple means what here? 90 logot jodi even number jodi multiply hoy thake, like 2, 4, 6, 8, these are known as even multiple. Jodi 90 logot jodi odd number multiple hoy thake, titele tak koa hobo odd multiple, like 1, 3, 5, 7. So in this case 90, that means if you see this 180 result, 180 result we can calculate like in this way. So another example, if you see here, logot aro eta example dekhoi disu, sin suppose 270 minus theta suppose, or you can write plus theta also or minus 2 dekhoi asu. So in this case what you have to write here, this one we have to write sin 3 into 90, 3 into 90 minus theta, you see here. Now this one is the difference, it is more comfortable here to understood. So yep, so here 90 into 2. So if 90 into 2, if multiple of even number then even multiple, if multiple of odd number then it is odd multiple. Is it clear? So what is the answer of this result and this result? Now let's see here. So after getting this one, so if any question given to us here, theta given, later on some values are given to you, so we have to convert this one into like in this in multiple form. So now in this case, if you see here 2 into 90, so first of all we have to identify in which quadrant the angle lies. A angle to the tumak je he amak je ya jitu angle dile 180 minus theta ba 2 into 90 minus theta, in which quadrant it lies we have to identify. So very simple, what you have to do here, yar kane ami ki kore, so if you make the xy plane here, suppose this one x, x dash, and here we have to write y, this one we have to write y dash. Now here you see, first of all 2 into 90, so how many 90s are there? 2 times. So that's why if we start from, starting point is here for the x axis or first quadrant, the yar by start one, if you write draw like in this way, so it represent 190. Yar by yar lage 90 degree hoy ne, then again if you represent up to this, then it is another 90 here. So how many 90s are there? 2 90s are there. So that's why 2 into 90, so 90 90, 2 times of 90 we get. Then after that what we get? Minus theta. Minus theta hole ki hobo? Back hobo. Plus theta hole ki hobo? Agbari hobo. So minus theta, that means it moves to next place, so that's why here we get this one in this case. So in this place the angle lies. Is it clear? So from here easily we can identify in this place the angle lies. If the angle lies here, in this one is second quadrant, according to our AST rule, ASTC, in second quadrant sine is what? Positive. So that's why here we get a positive value. Is it clear? That's why we get a positive value here. So after getting positive value, now if you see, if we get even multiple of 90, then the trigonometric function remains same. প্রথমে আমি সাইনটো আইডেন্টিফাই কৰিলোঁ, সাইনটো পজিটিভ হ'ল, তাৰপিছত আমি চাম যে যদি ইভেন মাল্টিপল হয় তে ত্ৰিগোনমেট্ৰিক ফাংচনটো কোনো চেঞ্জ নহয়, একে থাকিব। সো হোৱাট ইজ দ্য ত্ৰিগোনমেট্ৰিক ফাংচন হিয়াৰ সাইন, সো দেটছ ৱাই উই হেভ টু ৰাইট সাইন, এণ্ড দ্য এংগল ইজ হোৱাট হিয়াৰ থিটা, সো দেটছ ৱাই উই হেভ টু ৰাইট দিছ ৱান ইজ থিটা। সো দেট মিনচ আল্টিমেটলি সাইন 180 মাইনাছ থিটা ভেলু ইজ হোৱাট সাইন থিটা। ইজ ইট ক্লিয়াৰ? ওকে, নাও দ্য নেক্সট ওৱান ইজ ইউ চি হিয়াৰ 270 মাইনাছ থিটা। So in case of 270 minus theta, now here if we break this 270 minus theta, then we have to write 3 into 90 minus theta, 3 into 90. So if we write 3 into 90 here, now first of all we have to identify the sign, whether positive or negative. So in this case, if you see here, in this case if you see here 3 times of 90, if you start from here 1 90, then another 90, and the third 90 is here. Is it clear? And after that minus theta, that means back, that means in which quadrant? In third quadrant this angle lies. In third quadrant what is the sign of this trigonometry function sign? Obviously negative, ASTC, ASTC. So here in third quadrant sign negative, so that's why here automatically we put minus. Is it clear? Okay, now after that if you see here 3 into 90, since it is even multiple, so that's why the trigonometric function remains same. Sin hole sin e hoisile, kyo? Even multiple hoar karone. But in this case it is what? Odd multiple.
So if it is odd multiple, then the trigonometric function will be changed. Sin hole tar ulta to hobe. Sin or ulta to, in case of here, sin or ulta to in general ami to cosec jano, kintu yat trigonometric function yat ami jete angle bila find out karo, ta sin or ulta to yat cos. Cos or ulta sin, sin or ulta cos. Tan cot, cot tan. Sec cosec and cosec sec. Hal? So now in this case, sin first of all negative third quadrant, then here odd multiple, it is what? Odd multiple, so that's why the sign change, and here this sign change to cos, and the angle is what here? Theta, so that's how we have to write theta. Is it clear? So in this way, if any angle given to us, so easily we can identify like in this way. Is it clear? I think all of you understood this one. Now let's take an example here. So here some theories that we have done, now we consider an example. Suppose you have to find out the value of sine 210 degree. We have to find out the value of sine 210 degree. So how can we find out? So this result, so this one 210 degree, we have to convert this one into multiple of 90. So in this case what you have to write, you see here sine 210, that means divided by 90, how many times? Two times 180, 180 plus 30. That means we have to write this one is 2 into 90 plus 30. You see here. 180 plus 30, how much? 210. So this 210 easily we can break like in this way. Now after that, now we have to check out the sign here. In which quadrant it lies? 2 into 90. So here 90, then again 90, then plus 30. That means which quadrant? Third quadrant. In third quadrant it lies. 2 into 90, 90, 90 plus 30. So in third quadrant sine negative. So that's how we have to write minus. And after that you see even multiple. So remain same. So that's how we have to write sine. Is it clear? So angle is what here? 30. So that's how we have to write 30. I think all of you understood this one. So easily we can put the value here, sine. What is the value of sine 30? 1 by 2. So that's what we have to write here, 1 by 2. So the answer is minus 1 by 2. Is it clear? So in this way we can calculate the area. So the same thing in case of this one is degree measure. So if we consider this one in the radian measure, so in radian measure also we have to calculate the area. Is it clear? In radian measure also we can calculate. In radian measure what we get? We get in terms of pi. Radian measure hodai ki hobo in terms of pi thakibo or degree measure hole enge value thakibo. Is it clear? So here we complete our trigonometric part here. Again we start the complex number in our next class. Some polar forms or some calculations are there, and we need some the angles, whether it is positive angle or negative angle. So that's how we have to calculate these things. So that's why we discuss here today this trigonometric part. I think all of you understood this one.